The Flyers have come up big so far in the early season. Been exciting. The Flyers look better than most people anticipated. I'm excited to talk about it. Two games into this young season, and the Philadelphia Flyers have shown some real promise so far. First game of the season, the Flyers won 4-3 against the Chicago Blackhawks. This was a really good game. The Flyers came out with a lot of energy that game, and it was pretty consistent throughout the entire performance. We had big performances from Travis Konechny, put up a couple of goals, got another assist added later on, and it really stuck out in that game. Actually, offensively, scored one of the nicest goals that we've seen in quite a while, and probably going to be maybe one of the highlights of the year overall. Just a really beautiful performance by him. The line of Couturier, Lindblom, and Konechny have been very strong so far. Not really that surprising. Konechny and Couturier have played together quite a bit. Same with Lindblom. The three of them have kind of been around each other, so it really makes sense on paper. Couturier's defensive responsibility will make up for anything that the two rookies, any kind of mistakes the two rookies might make. Lindblom is generally relatively responsible, and Konechny has an elite skill set from an offensive standpoint, so he can really compensate for any of his defensive woes, which really haven't been there that much this year. So far, just overall as a team, this team is playing far better defensively. I mean, even going back to the preseason, you can look, there are far less two-on-ones, far less breakdowns, far less performances that are consistent where you see complete mismanagement over and over again. There have been some spurts of that in the preseason, but as we've kind of entered the games that mean something, we've seen definitely a difference in their performance. The first game of the season for sure, second game even more I'll go over that a little bit later. But for now, the initial performance of 4-3, thought that was a really strong performance by the Flyers to come out. Carter Hart played well. He didn't play out of this world, but he played well. He outperformed the other goaltender, and that's really what the Flyers need him to do on a regular basis. Giving up three goals doesn't seem like a great game for him, but really... it did seem like a night where, maybe his numbers didn't reflect his actual performance, because he was pretty solid. Three goals is not great, but it's also not bad, especially when you win the game. You got to always think of it kind of relative to your competition. Defensively, a lot of people were kind of really hard on Provorov. He had one turnover. I saw like one strong one. Other than that, he still played 24 minutes. I've seen some complaints about his performance, but at the end of the day, you look at the lineup, they're using him more than everybody else. So clearly the management and the staff do not agree with the criticism. And I personally do not really agree. I've seen a couple of mistakes, but again, he plays against the best players on the other team. I do not expect him to have a mistake-free game. I know everybody expects that, but he's 22 years old. I don't see that. I don't see that around the league. I don't see any 22-year-old defenseman playing mistake-free hockey. I haven't seen it, so I don't know why the onus is put on Provorov to play that caliber. I think he's getting there, and I think the goal that he created, that he later got an assist for, if you watch the way he drives up the middle, I see a lot of people pretty harsh on him. Provorov is an elite skilled player. I know people want to pull him off the power play. I do not agree with that statement whatsoever. I think the Flyers just have an abundance right now, and we are seeing it. A lot of the youth isn't fully developed, and that's probably why this team isn't on paper the scariest lineup, but it's because of the potential mixed with where they are right now. But we're seeing a little bit of that. The defense is filling out really nicely. Braun playing with Provorov is working relatively well. Niskanen and Sanheim definitely look good together. Ghost in the first game of the season, in the 4-3 game, had a really good performance. Overall, I just think he moves the puck well. In AV system, he moves the puck well. On the power play, they've changed things up a little bit. They have him passing less and shooting more. They're using both sides of the ice. It's a lot of the moving to Giroux to the right side is to create that, these quick passes back to the point. I think it's been relatively effective, actually. I don't know if this is the best we're going to see from them, but I really want to see what happens as they kind of evolve and learn to play this new system. I've seen a lot of promise. Top line, Hayes has been good, but sloppy at times, making some weird plays where taking a bad penalty for no reason. Did it during the preseason. See a little bit of it, but not that big of a deal. He seems to have a lot of energy, personality-wise, so maybe that's what comes with it. Overall, strong player, PK-wise, physically, see him go to the net quite a bit, and, you know, now that he's playing with G and Voracek, you know, there's definitely potential there. I'd love to see a top line with Couturier, Voracek, and Giroux on there, but, you know, I'm okay with this. I think this is a pretty good way to balance out that top six, but I would, you know, I would still challenge the coaches to try that. Get that legit top line out there. Kevin Hayes probably would do a very serviceable job with Lindblom and Konecny as well. I would try it. At least I would start trying it at practice. Right now, the way the team is playing, I probably wouldn't mess with it too much. But it was something I would revert back to, try to create a true top line. And that comes to the third line. Scott Laughton has played well. Offensively, he's been pretty quiet. Kind of expect that in the third line role, especially playing center. He's pretty defensively responsible. But he's had some good plays. He had a really nice pass, created a goal to Konecny. He's a good player. He just really is. He's a solid player. And I suspect he might, you know, be a long-time flyer just because he plays well in every aspect of the game, and especially in your bottom six. Him, Raffle, Twarinski has looked solid every single game. Butterman is pretty good, still looks like an NHLer. I'm interested to see what happens as he moves forward, but I think Twarinski, I have not seen any regression in his play at all, from preseason to regular season. Now he's been a little less offensively effective, but that's expected. The energy is still there. The aggressiveness, the physicality is still there. It seems to me like he's here to stay. And it's awesome to see, quite frankly. Bunneman, I need to see a little bit more. But good. Not bad. Not bad at all. And obviously, clearly an NHL player. And maybe one that can produce points at some point in the NHL as well. So that'd be cool. Carter Hart played well. Obviously, Elliott has not played. Coaching, PK, looks really strong. Really strong. Mike Yeo definitely deserves some credit for that. Jamie Bascow, he's been mentioning that to me nonstop, and you know, it's quite clear you can see the way the team plays far more aggressive penalty kill, and it's definitely working for them. Power play, good movement so far. Still early. I think power play got to judge later in the season anyway, but so far it's good. They're moving the puck. They don't look completely ineffective. We'll see how it goes. It could get worse. Could get better. I want to see a little bit longer, and that kind of gets me to the next game here. Flyers come in, second game of the season after a long break in between, come in and beat the New Jersey Devils and Wayne Simmonds at home in their home opener. It was a beautiful game, at least from a standpoint of entertainment as a Flyers fan. It was just great to see them come out. You know, they came out a little flat-footed, not too bad though, nothing to panic over, which is kind of expected because they had a lot of days off, so they really needed more time to kind of get their legs back. So kind of expected them to come into the second period with a lot more energy. New Jersey had a balanced play in that first period. After that, Flyers completely took over, and you know, they scored a series of goals. Couturier had a goal. Provorov had a beautiful goal. Konecny, another steal, another goal. You know, that second line is really just producing right now. Teams will adjust, but then all of a sudden that'll free up that first line, and then hopefully Nolan Patrick is back. And if you have a third line of Patrick, JVR, Twarinski, I don't know, Laughton, whoever they want to put on there, honestly, call it Farabee, that's pretty freaking solid. And then maybe as the season evolves, you could even switch centers up over time. Who knows? Who knows what will happen? But right now, the Flyers have a pretty deep team. You know, this 4-0 win is not that big of a deal because New Jersey's struggling. But good teams take advantage of bad teams, or at least teams that are struggling. And the Flyers made New Jersey look worse than people anticipated. The Flyers don't look like the same team that they were in the preseason, but they were working through a lot of kinks. This is what happens when you bring in a new coaching staff. Anybody tells you that coaching wouldn't change anything, it's just absolutely not true. It's not that that coaching will fix your problems, or one player will fix your problems, or two players will fix your problems, or the way you put your lineup will fix your problems. It just doesn't work like that. It's everything encompassing. It is a recipe, a formula, and everything matters. Every aspect of it matters. The right coach, the right assistant coach, the right penalty kill coach, the right goaltending coach, you know, and all of these guys are competent, and all these guys are smart, so it's about finding the right combination. The one thing I did love is in between the games, the Flyers had an optional skate, took it, went in on their own. You're seeing the team bond. The losses in preseason obviously have worked to a degree. AV's system, they're buying it, and you can see it. They look fun, and that is really exciting. They legitimately look fun to watch, and I'm excited to see what happens as the season evolves. They haven't been perfect by any stretch, but they're really, we can continuously attack. The Flyers can continuously attack. All three pairings on defense are good. There's no more anchor. Doesn't exist. Doesn't exist within this lineup. In fact, the Flyers have too many defensemen to send down Phil Myers. What a luxury the Flyers have that they have a player like Phil Myers in the minors right now. You know, it probably won't stay that way. I imagine he's going to make his way to the NHL, and then the luxury will probably go away. There were a lot of scouts there tonight. The Flyers must be working on some kind of deal. They have cap issues. They have they need to free up some space. I don't know exactly how they're going to do that, but they might try to offload some of the cap hit that they're eating. That might be, you know, even just trading a pick. They don't necessarily have to trade a player or, you know, do something complicated, but they might need some cap space. I don't know if they know when Nolan Patrick is going to be back. Again, this is a migraine disorder. This is not a concussion issue. This is a medication wait and see type of situation. Reduce your stress, change your diet, fix these type of things. But overall, Nolan Patrick will probably find his way back. If you search migraines, just Google search it. I mean, I am not an expert by any stretch, so I'm sure people can call me out. It's totally fine. But if you just look up migraine disorders, they are not that uncommon. And if you just look up athletes that have had migraine disorders, just off the top of my head, Troy Aikman, Scottie Pippen. Again, you know, these are just a couple of the names I can think of off the top of my head from the list that I saw. It's not that uncommon, but it is something that they're going to have to manage with Nolan Patrick. And I don't think it's a head injury thing. It might be one of these things where, you know, maybe the kid's not living as right as he should be. And that doesn't mean that he's living poorly by anybody's standards. But again, if it's a disorder, there's just extra precautions. So I don't want to blame him in any way. But again, this is probably something that's solvable, so nobody needs to panic. And when he does come back, I do suspect the Flyers will have one of the fastest, highest rolling offenses in the East. They don't have everything, but they have a lot of attack, and they still have Claude Giroux, one of the best players of all time, and one of the best players in Flyers history, clearly. You know, people shouldn't forget that. This team has everything right now, and if Provorov continues the progress, which is what I see, and I thought this game in particular, I mean, he made maybe one mistake or so, maybe two, but overall, just, you know, really solid game from him again. And I think we should just pretty much anticipate that for this season. It's about the way the team plays, and right now I really like what AV's doing. AV looks happy to be here. Quite frankly, he seems like he's pretty happy where he is. I mean, he's got a couple kids in the minors right now that I know he would want at the NHL level. It is kind of a luxury. He's got a 21-year-old goaltender who's doing things that, you know, Carhartt broke a franchise record today, right? You know, I think the youngest goaltender in Flyers history to have a shutout. He's here. I mean, I tweeted this earlier. It's like the New Jersey Devils were watching Martin Brodeur in our net. It was awesome. It was awesome. The save he made. You know what I mean? I know some other players can make that save. You know, some other Flyers goaltenders have made exceptional saves. Neuver was extremely athletic. Mason had some great years here. None of them are capable of doing what Carter Hart has done, especially not at 21. Mason even had monster rookie year, but you got to think he played Ken Hitchcock around a defensive system. This is not a defensive system. This is Carter Hart doing something special right now, and it's amazing to see. And if he can continue to doing this, and if he does continue to become the player that I see him as, you know, he could get better as the year goes on. And at that point, you know, people might actually be talking about the Flyers as a contender. You know, he has that ability. I don't know if he's ready to do that, but, you know, the same credit that's given other teams with elite goalies, that's going to start coming to the Flyers if, you know, as long as this continues. I don't see why not, though. The kid has everything you pretty much ask for. But overall, again, in this game, penalty kill super strong. You know, again, Hayes took a bad penalty. I don't really know what he was thinking. You know, reached down off the faceoff after a penalty was just taken. Couturier honestly got away with one before that. He should have got a hooking call, and then he threw it out over the glass. So then he had to take a penalty. Then Hayes takes another bad penalty right afterwards. And at that point, you're worried. And that's where Carter Hart comes up big. That's a huge momentum save. You know, Flyers are up 1-0 at that point. And then next thing you know, Flyers dominate the game. You know, score three or two goals in succession. You know, goal later on by Konechny. And they just, they continue to attack. And they gave up, you know, a couple chances. But overall, nothing really seemed that threatening. It seemed like the Flyers were in control of the game. And I believe they were. And I think we're seeing some good stuff here. The Flyers are going to have some more tough competition. They're going to go over west. They're going to play Vancouver, who, you know, as of earlier that I saw tonight, was dominating LA. LA is also playing back-to-back. Vancouver is not going to be our toughest opponent, but they are quick. They're fast. They're young. They're going to have the energy. We're going to be tired traveling over there. It'll be interesting. I think the Flyers have a better team on paper, definitely on defense. You know, but Vancouver is growing a really nice core there. I mean, Elias Pettersson obviously is fantastic. They have Besser. They have Quinn Hughes, another Hughes brothers, right? We get to play two Hughes brothers in a row. Quinn Hughes scored a ridiculous goal tonight. Slapper from the point. They just got talent. They have talent. So it's going to be an interesting game. And then after that, you know, we go Calgary and then the Oilers. Then back home, Stars. And I will be at that game. I will be at the game against the Stars. In the press box, in the locker room, and then, you know, in the press conference as well, do the whole shebang. And then I'll probably do a video about that too. So look out for that one. But right now, you gotta love what we've seen so far. It's been interesting. Not just good, not just playing well. Interesting, interesting offensively. Drew, a little snake bitten, but also you can see it. It's kind of picking up. And as the team plays better, Claude Drew gets better. So that's the thing, you know. He put up over 100 points a few years ago when the team was rolling. That's what we want to see. If this team is rolling, you see, you know, 100-point season from Claude Giroux. I don't know if 100, but, you know, 90-point season from Claude Giroux. 80, 85-point season from Couturier. Maybe back to 75, 80-point season from Voracek. If this team can produce offensively as a unit, they will produce points and they will show the league. And then, you know, and things will change. But again, all optimistic. I personally am strong on them this year. I think they are a mysterious team, and that's why people doubt them. People usually doubt mystery, but they're really only going off of last year. If you look at everything as a whole, Flyers are set up for success. We've just been waiting for it. It just comes slower. It comes slower than we expect. But here it is, and I'm looking for the next game.